Your voice, your opinion, your community. Fact TV, free speech protected.
Good evening, everyone. I hope everyone's doing well. Welcome to the class of 2023's class night. First and foremost, I want to congratulate all of my fellow classmates for finally meeting all my friends. Okay, we're working now. Let me start. Good evening, everyone. I hope everyone is doing well. Welcome to the class of 2023's class night. First and foremost, I want to congratulate all of my fellow classmates for finally meeting all our expectations in the school and being eligible to graduate. I'd like to thank all of the families, members, and friends who have supported each individual student throughout our 4 years of high school. I'd also love to give thanks to our amazing community who makes it so easy to be a Terry. Last but not least, I'd also love to give great appreciation to all the amazing teachers and faculty members that have helped us get through these years and also have helped us strive to be the best students we can be. I want everyone to soak in all of these amazing times that we've spent together because I believe our class is one of the best that has come through the school. I thank all of you for being here tonight, and I want everyone to remember, regardless if you walk out of here with an award or not, that does not determine who you are in your future. We all have worked so hard to be here. I know some of us are ready to run off and some of us are here to stay, but one thing for sure, let's enjoy our last couple weeks together before we all go our separate ways. When we do take those steps into our future and step strong, know that I'm truly proud to represent this class as a class president. Thank you guys all so much.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome. And first, I want to start by saying congratulations to the class of 2023. These guys and girls are absolutely amazing. They've done a lot of hard work, they've taken a lot of different avenues, and I'd like you to give them a big round of applause. They should really. But I'm going to start by thanking everyone for coming out tonight. We're proud of each and every member of this graduating class. These students have worked hard to reach this final culminating event or a series of events, as the way we do it as Interior. The scholarship awards tonight, the decision process begins with the student submitting an application for any or all awards in which they're interested and qualified for. Once the student applications are received, they are sent to each scholarship committee for consideration. In many cases, personal interviews are also conducted. Finally, each committee chooses a student, or in some cases, students, to receive their scholarship award. This is never an easy process, because there are so many talented and deserving students from which to choose. I'd like to further it by saying how proud I am by the amount that we give out each year as a small community, but a very generous community. And just to let everyone know a little bit of information, tonight we will be giving out in the region of about $162,000, as well as adding on to this the $84,000 renewal for UVM scholarship. That's almost $250,000. That is absolutely phenomenal. And I thank the community. Our families, our relatives, all of these lovely people behind me, the hard work they go through to continually raise money to make sure that our kids are looked after and they get sent off in a very good way. So, thank you all. I'm going to start the evening's proceedings with the Gail Christmas Recognition of Achievement Award. Gail Christmas, she was a very near and dear person who worked here many years. She worked from 1998 to 2013. She worked hard to help all students be successful, and she was willing to do whatever it takes, whatever was necessary to get students to the point of success. She embodied the role of teacher, mother, grandmother, counselor, friend, compatriot, worker, co-worker, any role that she had to play, she would play. She always said the best way that she could reach her students is by treating them as if they were her own children. In memory of, and with love and gratitude for Mrs. Christmas and her enduring commitment, we'll honor three students tonight who emulate traits that she instilled in her students and in all of us. And these are perseverance in the face of adversity, willingness to accept support, patience, compassion, determination, endurance, and most of all, the love of reading. It's our honor to recognize the following recipients of the Gail Christmas Recognition of Achievement Award, and their names, they'll go to the plaque in the library that is continually kept there. And she would certainly be proud of you and the determination and perseverance that you have exhibited throughout your school career. So without further ado, Aaliyah Cox, Diamond Oaks, and Faith Lee Picard. Yeah. Okay, now I'm going to hand it over to Ms. McKay to continue the ceremony.
Up and down quite a bit. Okay, the next award is our BFUHS Retirement Awards. These are going to be presented by John Bradley for Mr. Bennett, Miss Kelly Spaulding, and Miss Susan Swan.
So, we've got three retirees this year, and Mr. Bennett unfortunately could not be here tonight. Those of you that know Mr. Bennett, he's been here for many years, I believe 14 or 15 years. He did plan on retiring this year, and unfortunately, some health issues got a little bit in the way just over the Christmas period. I've spoken to him a lot recently, and he's on the mend and doing well. And sorry he's not here tonight, but he wishes all you folks a great success in your futures. And to honour him, we give out an honorary award each year, each time someone retires. And Mr. Bennett, when he was faced with his choice, he had a few students in mind. And he was very clear, though, on this one student who was very diligent and very... She persevered. She had a good relationship with Mr. Bennett, and she always took advice from him. She always gave him advice, which he loved. And he felt that this young lady had pursued a lot through the pandemic, a lot through her own life, and he is just amazed by her. So, Diamond, can you come up and see what's going on?
Hi, I'm Kelly Spaulding. Congratulations to all the class of 2023. So proud of you. My award is actually going to three young men in this class who I was looking back at pictures of us back during COVID, and I found a picture of these three guys on like the bench in my room. And they just were thumbs up. And it made me think back to just how much we've been through together and just how much their upbeatness and positiveness just really helped that out. My word's going to Wyatt Lesford, Jake Tretler, and Alex Leonard. Thank you.
Congratulations to the class of 2023. It is an honor to be sharing graduation with you. Kudos to you, it only took you 4 years to graduate from these hallowed halls. It took me 33. I have had few harder decisions or more difficult decisions than selecting one of you as a scholarship winner. It has been a pleasure and a privilege working with all of you.
I'd like to thank those of you who have shown an inquisitive nature in the area of mathematics. You've challenged me with great questions and shown tenacious energy. I'd also like to recognize and thank those who have exhibited grit and perseverance while perhaps disliking every minute. The lessons that you learned about yourselves in those moments are bigger than the math that you learned. It has therefore truly been an honor working with all of you. I have selected a person who, as I see it, is a humble, quiet leader with a kind heart, genuine, caring, and inclusive of others, who possesses a brilliant mind, perseveres without complaint, and is not afraid to stretch outside of his comfort zone so as to grow in character and knowledge. Recently named ELPS Student of the Month, for these reasons and many others, please help me congratulate Cameron Gage.
Right, our next award is going to be the Alumni Scholarships, and that's going to be presented by Mr. Thomas McPhee.
On behalf of the Alumni Association, I have the pleasure, as Alumni Scholarship Chairman, of presenting 20 awards tonight. Barbara Cray Spolino, Class of 1940 Award, given in memory of the first female senior class president, Barbara Cray. This $400 award is presented annually to the senior class president. Award this year goes to Kate Nassel. The night of the interviews, smart casual changes the perception as to cap and gown. I don't know who the hell you are. 64 years ago, a single $400 scholarship was awarded to a member of the class of 1958. 331 graduates have now received alumni scholarships. The Alumni Scholarship Committee interviewed 19 members of the senior class, and for the first time ever, we are awarding 19 scholarships. I've asked Class President Haskell to assist me in handing out alumni scholarships, because like I said, I don't know who you are in cap and gown. $500 alumni scholarships are awarded to Cameron Gage, Ezra Holloway, Jameson Nystrom, Raymond Plummer, and Olivia Ribes. $1,000 alumni scholarships are awarded to Kayla Aldridge, Ella Clark, Janet Dolliff, Caleb Gia, Emma Hillard, Gavin Joy, Austin Malin, Ashlyn Maxfield, Gwendolyn McGrath, and Jake Moore and Mary Wallace. The $2,000 Charles E. Russell Alumni Scholarship is awarded to Grace Warriors. $4,000 Paul J. Obolowski Alumni Scholarship is awarded to Juliana McDermott. The $6,000 Thomas H. McPhee Alumni Scholarship is awarded to Kaylin Haskell. As a footnote, the Alumni Scholarship Committee met on Monday evening to adopt Scholarship Committee bylaws drafted by Attorney Ray Masuko before his untimely passing last September. At the end of the meeting, we were reviewing the roster of past alumni scholarship winners and how much money each recipient was awarded. From 1958 to 1970, the alumni was only awarding $400 scholarships each year to one member of the senior class. Then it jumped to $1,000. But what really caught my eye was the $400 scholarship in 1965. It went to Brian Haskell.
All right, our next award is the Messina Temple Scholarship in Eastern Star, presented by Mrs. Sally McPhee.
Good evening, and congratulations to the class of 2023. I have the pleasure tonight of giving scholarships for the Bellows Falls Masonic Association and for the Eastern Star. These scholarships are awarded on scholastic achievements and mainly for your commitment to the community. We feel that it's very important for all of us to give back at some time. The first scholarship is from the Masonic Association for $500 to Caleb Gia. I have four $1,000 scholarships for the Eastern Star. They are given to Caden Haskell, Julia McDermott, Mary Wallace, and Caden Gage.
Our next award is the Shannon Reed Brunel Memorial Scholarship, presented by Mr. Jonathan Brunel and Riker Brunel.
Hello, class of 2023. We're here to give the scholarship for Shannon Reed Brunel. That was my wife and my son's mother passed away several years ago. I gotta say, every year we drive down here. It's a pleasure to come back here. I'm actually a 1990 alum from here. Shannon was in 1992. I sat here in 1990, a solid C student. I'm taking any scholarships, so. But it's okay. I went on to get an associate's, a bachelor's, a master's, have a military career, work at IBM. I now work for Lockheed Martin, so if you want a job. So, 1992, Shannon sat here. She had the sash. She had all everything. She had the scholarships, and she did really well. So congratulations. really proud of you. It's nice to come. I won an amazing job setting, so I put that.
The points from the women.
It's very proud. I'm very proud to come home and actually see this school. It's an incredible school. We drive down from Burlington, so it's a little bit different. For my son's going in the ninth grade next year, so it's definitely a different world. It's very homey. You guys are together, your own family. This class will always be together. I'm 33 years old. So it's nice to be here. So the 2023 Henry Brownell Memorial Scholarship, $1,000, will go to
Ashlyn Maxfield.
Going to be the Emblem Club Scholarship that's going to be presented by Miss Diane Palmer.
I know it says Liz Walker, but she's not here. The Emblem Club gives two awards in the amounts of $300 and $500 to a Bellows Falls Union High School senior who has shown academic promise, financial need, good citizenship, and community involvement. Congratulations, class of 2023. I know you've all done a lot of hard work to get here, and I know you'll do well in the future. Tonight, it gives me great pleasure to award $300 scholarship to Cameron Gage. $500 to Austin Mellon.
All right, the next awards are the Polish American Club Scholarship and the Elk Scholarship and Maurice Dexter Baseball Award. These are both presented by Miss Ellen Podgorski.
Good evening and congratulations, class of 2023. The first award I'm going to give is for the Polish American Club Scholarship, which is for $1,500. And I am pleased to announce that the recipient is Gavin Joy. The Elk Scholarship is awarded to a senior who has attended Bellows Falls Union High School for a minimum of 2 years and ranks within the top third of their class. The recipient will demonstrate academic promise, financial need, community involvement, and a clear articulation of career plans and goals. I am pleased to announce this year we have two recipients of the $500 scholarship, Austin Milan and Juliana McDermott.
All
Kelly. The Morris Dexter Baseball Award is presented to a senior baseball player who displays leadership, dedication, hard work, and sacrifice. I am pleased to announce this year's recipient is Jameson Niceford.
We have four awards now. So the American Legion Auxiliary Scholarships and Citizenship Medal, the American Legion Scholarships and Citizenship Medal. Okay. Christopher J. Kirkle Scholarship for Continuing Education and the Savoy Fuller Memorial Scholarship. All of these are going to be presented by Miss Marcy Smith.
Congratulations. I'd like to reiterate what Jonathan Brunel said. I was sitting where you are 29 years ago, and I figured that was the last time I was ever going to step foot in this place. I was out of here. See you later. Well, here I am. I've had a child graduate from here, and I've been the president of the American Legion Auxiliary here in Bellows Falls for about 18 years. I, at this point, sometimes wing it. I sometimes have something written. But I must say that I've been over to Fall Mountain the last same amount of time. And I always go over there and I present, and then I always come back here to home and realize that the purple and the white gowns and everybody dressed up, everybody doing the pomp and circumstance and the singing and the band is just totally worth it. So if you ever get on this side and experience other stuff, you'll know this is why you call this home. So tonight I'm here to present the American Legion Auxiliary Pierce Lawton Unit 37. Many of you, maybe not so much this class, participated with the auxiliary. I've always posted, pushed out to the guidance, community service opportunities. We are big on community service. We are big on serving veterans, and we're big on doing poppies, community service to our place, students. That's what we like. So we would like to recognize people tonight. Each of these are $500 each. One goes to Kaylee Aldrich and Cameron Gage. I'm also here to present the American Legion Auxiliary Citizenship Medal. The medal is awarded to a senior girl embodying the five qualities of honor, moral courage, leadership, service, and scholarship. She must have contributed to the welfare of the community and has been chosen solely by her teachers. This year, $100, a citizenship medal goes to Grace Warris. Presenter for Post 37, made up of veterans locally, veterans that have moved, veterans that are in the Bennington Veterans Home or other veterans homes. Tonight I am presenting for them. I'll do their Citizenship Medal Award. It goes to Jake Moore. Post Post 37 has an Edmund Waller Scholarship for $500 to Juliana McDermott. Post 37 awards the Richard Tutt Long Scholarship in $500 to Grace Warius. Post 37 Earl Gilman Scholarship in the amount of $500 to Cameron Gage. This is the Dale Burke Scholarship. This is in the amount of $7,500. It goes to Gavin Joy. Tonight, I'm also a presenter. I was a presenter. I have now become the administrator of this scholarship. It was originally set up by Thomas Hall, who also was a 1992 graduate of Bellows Falls. He funded this scholarship in memory of his friend Chris Kirkle. Unfortunately, Tom passed away in August unexpectedly. I worked for him for 10 years, and so over time, I took over information from him. So he started this on behalf of the class of 92 in memory of their friend and classmate, Chris Kirkle. He was passionate about farming, agriculture, and an avid hunter who always had his first deer on the first day within the first hour. He was just that lucky. Unfortunately, he died from a medical condition in 2008. His daughter also attended school here, was a graduate a few years ago. If he was still here today, he would probably be bullying and jamming on the farm, driving his little VW rabbit car. And if anyone remembered Chris, he was a very tall, boisterous man, and how he could fit in a two-door little VW rabbit is still beyond me. And he would also ride around with his hunting gun in the back window, because back then he could still do that. So this year, it was just myself, because Tom, unfortunately, is not here. So I went through the scholarships, and again, with all of these applications for everything that I've presented tonight, it's always hard to decide who to give something to, because you're all deserving in one way or another. This scholarship was set up by Tom for continuing your education in farming or agriculture, or going into a vocational trade school, junior college, technical school, or trade school. This year, it's $500 will be awarded to the recipient after the first semester grades and proof of second enrollment for the second semester. It's $500 to Jenna Dahl. Multiple people reaching out asking if I could just do their scholarship, so I'm just spending the night with you. So this is, I'm a presenter for the class of 75 Savoy Fuller Scholarship. Their committee in the class of 75 would like you to know a little bit about this scholarship. It was created in 1996 in memory of our two classmates that had gone before us, Roland Savoy and Dana Fuller. Since then, we have lost more of our former classmates, and it has strengthened the friendships that we forged as children. Roland was gracious and kind and loved life. However, he lost his life to a kidney dysfunction just weeks before we were to graduate. He had plans for his life. Although he endured pain and discomfort daily, he hid that well from most of his classmates. Dana was full of warmth and loved children. He stayed in Bellows Falls after graduation and became a member of many things in town, including the Bellows Falls Fire Department. It was Dana's commitment to the community that cost him his young life. He died of smoke inhalation along with another young firefighter while trying to ensure that others had safely gotten out from a burning hotel in December of 1981. And this is where the memorial is, down in Bellows Falls across from the subway. We in the class of 1975 are keenly aware of the two classmates that weren't able to fully realize their dreams. Along with the others that we have lost so young, it is in their memories and honor that we are able to help other young people with similar dreams. We hope that as you enter the next stage in your life, that you will remember our class motto, the higher you climb, the wider your horizons. Congratulations, all the best. I do not have a money figure on this one, but it goes to Jenna Dahl. Thank you and congratulations, and I hope everyone has great success. Thank you. The next award is the William J. Snoddy Memorial Scholarship presented by Miss Virginia Corson.
Congratulations, class of 2023. It is with great pleasure that Mrs. Corson and I are here representing the Terrier Booster Club in presenting the William J. Snoddy Scholarship, given in memory of William Snoddy, who was a foreign language teacher here at the high school for many years. These scholarships are made possible through the generous donations of food, purchase of merchandise, concessions, and monetary donations. This year, we are able to present 14 scholarships to members of the senior class, totaling, now pay attention please, because Mrs. Corson wanted me to be sure that this was the right amount, $9,999.92. Each in the amount of $714.28. And six scholarships totaling $2,053.40, each in the amount of $342.20. I always look forward to this night and seeing students, many of whom I had the pleasure of teaching, being recognized for their accomplishments and taking the next big step forward in their educational and post-high school journey. Before I announce the recipients, I'd like to take a moment to let everyone know what a difficult time the scholarship committee had in choosing the recipients, as all were highly qualified and all demonstrated excellence in academics, community service, co-curricular activities, and interview skills. I also feel it's important to mention the caliber of schools students who interviewed with the Booster Club will be attending: University of Vermont, University of Nevada, Las Vegas, Ithaca, University of Rochester, Culinary Institute of America, Salve Regina, Bridgewater State University, Coastal Carolina University, Johnson & Wales, Springfield College, St. Anselm, St. Joseph's College of Maine, University of Rhode Island, State University of New York Purchase, Russell Sage, WyoTech, Vermont EMS Academy, and UTI Exton, Pennsylvania. Majors included psychology, health science and occupational therapy, automotive collision and restoration, business, criminology, cinema and photography, criminal justice, music and studio composition, restaurant and food services, accounting, game design and development, nursing, business, economics, exercise science, diesel technology, marketing, athletic training, radiology, computer science, and history. Well done, class of 2023. The 14 recipients of the William J. Snoddy Scholarship from the graduating class are Grace Warriors, Caden Haskell, Austin Mallon, Isabel Perry, Raymond Plummer, Noah Simino, Jake Moore, Joseph Jock, Gavin Joy, Kaylee Aldridge, Ella Clark, Cameron Gage, Caleb Gia, and Jameson Nystrom. In addition, we are pleased to present the 6 scholarships given to former BFUHS students who have gone on to institutes of higher learning. These awards will be mailed to the recipients. This year, it is our pleasure to present these awards to Ariana Wonderly, Jaya Karen, Kagan Illingworth, Tyler Stanley, Megan Kelly, and Grace Wilkinson. Our next scholarship is in memory of Harry Weiser. The Harry E. Weiser Award is presented annually by the Terrier Booster Club to a graduating senior in memory of Harry Weiser, principal here at Bellows Falls Union High School for many years. Bud, as he was fondly called by colleagues, friends, and family, had a strong connection to both athletics and student council. This year's recipient was chosen by members of the scholarship committee and represents what Bud stood for: honesty, integrity, dedication, and the ability to speak out and stand up for their beliefs. This student's name will be placed on the perpetual plaque that hangs here at the high school. This year's award of $100 and the book, Anyway, 10 Paradoxical Commandments, Finding Personal Meaning in a Crazy World, goes to Grace Worry. Congratulations, class of 2023.
All right, the next two awards are the BF Rotary Club Scholarships and the BF Rotary Club Medal for Most Improved Student. This will be presented by Mrs. Marty Gallagher.
Well, I have to say, Ginny and Mary Lou, you are a tough act to follow. Welcome. Good evening and congratulations. As a graduate at Bellows Falls Union High School, I'm honored to be here tonight to present the Bellows Falls Rotary Club Scholarships. The Rotary Club of Bellows Falls is proud to be celebrating their 100th year anniversary of serving and supporting the community. Tonight, I will be giving away 4 scholarships. The first is the Rotary Club Medal Scholarship in the amount of $500. This scholarship is awarded to a graduating senior who, through perseverance, has shown continuous improvement while at Bellows Falls Union High School. And this award is selected by the Bellows Falls Union High School Faculty Awards Committee. This award goes to Hunter Morgan. Bellows Falls Rotary Club Scholarships in the amount of $1,000 each are awarded to 3 students who have not only excelled academically, but but have also demonstrated a commitment to making a positive impact in our community. The recipients of tonight's awards are Jenna Dahl, Gavin Joy, and Julianne Rinder. Congratulations all.
All right, the next award is the Terry Brown Little Hustler Award, presented by Mr. Mike Brown and Mr. Warren Mishur.
Hey, how are you tonight? I'm Mike Brown, and from Dunedin, Florida, and I came up here, and I send my best regards from my father, Richard E. Brown, and my sister, Karen E. Brown. She's from down Florida. They say congratulations to the class. It's great to be here. The Little Hustler Award is what it sounds like. You know, a lot of you played sports, and if you can take that with you the rest of your life, in everything you play, I played ping pong all day long, and I never lost. You know, and I never fell to the floor of my father's barn at 20 Henry Street. So that's good news. You know where 20 Henry Street is, right? Well, there was a basketball court out there, and Terry Brown, my brother, had ferocious games. Snow, sleet, rain, didn't matter. We played, and he never beat me. But who was the hero of the game? It wasn't me. It was him. And he was a hero because he never gave up. Never, ever give up. You've heard that all your life, but take that to heart. No matter what you're doing, try as hard as you can and give it all you have and make it all the best that you can. Thank you.
There are quite a few things to consider when choosing a recipient for this award, as with the others. This student must exemplify many of the same qualities as Terry did. He or she must not only prove they have the determination and team spirit to encourage others to do better, but he or she must have the stamina, strength, willingness, and dedication to always give the extra effort to get the job done. This year, it is with great pleasure that we present a check for the Terry Brown Little Hustler Award in the amount of $850 to Raymond Plummer.
Thank you.
All right, the next award is the Robert B. Edmond Scholarship and Chroma Scholarships, presented by Ms. Ann Stanley.
Hello and congratulations. On behalf of the employee owners of Chroma Technology, I would like to congratulate all of this year's graduates of the 2023 class. I'm pleased to be here tonight. I'm presenting three scholarships to three members of the 2022 graduating class of the Middle High School. First of these is the 18th Annual Robert B. Edmond Scholarship. This award is made in memory of one of Chroma's early employee owners and is given to a graduate who is continuing his or her education in the area of either mathematics or the sciences and exhibits real enthusiasm for his or her chosen field. The total value of this scholarship is $10,000, with a $2,500 award each year for the 4 years, as long as the recipient maintains a minimum 2.5 GPA. It is my privilege to award the Robert Edmond Scholarship for 2023 to Julianne Rinder.
Next is the award for the 6th Annual Chroma Technology Scholarship, awarded to the student that has shown a strong commitment to furthering his or her education, as well as resilience in the face of adversity and unusual hardship. The total value of this scholarship is also $10,000, with a $2,500 award each year for 4 years, as long as the recipient maintains a 2.5 GPA. It is my honor to award the 6th Annual Chroma Technology Scholarship to Joseph Jones. Chroma's last award for 2023 is the 8th Annual Chroma Technology Community College Scholarship, awarded to a graduating senior who is planning to continue his or her education in the fields of mathematics or the sciences within the framework of a 2-year college program. This scholarship is valued at $2,500 with a $1,250 award each of the 2 years, as long as the recipient maintains a GPA of 2.5. I am very pleased to present this award to Noah Smith. The next award is the Westminster Fire and Rescue Scholarship, presented by Mr. David Russell.
Good evening. Westminster would be honored to give two scholarship awards tonight, the value of $800 to Juliana McDurbin and Hannah Nerth.
Next award is the BF Women's Club Amy Searless Scholarship, presented by Mrs. Betty Haggerty.
Congratulations, class of 2023. Where you are at this moment is like a foundation for the rest of your life. So I challenge you to go forward, build upon it. We know you will do well. You will make yourselves proud, your families proud, your community proud, as they are this evening in celebrating you. The Bellows Falls Women's Club has a long-standing presence in our greater communities. They were formed or organized in 1901. Early on in its community service, it hired Amy Searles to be the first district nurse, a program that was a forerunner of today's Visiting Nurse Alliance. So here we are, 119 years later, honoring the nursing profession by awarding a scholarship to a graduating student who, as selected by the Faculty Awards Committee, is pursuing training in nursing or other health care occupation. It is my pleasure, on behalf of the Bellows Falls Women's Club members, to award the 2023 Amy Searles Scholarship in the amount of $2,000 to Ashlyn Maxfield.
Okay, our next award is the Jada Spalding Doyle Memorial Scholarship, presented by Miss Annette Spalding and Miss Emma Spalding.
A everybody. It's so great to see all of you. And congratulations. I'm so happy for all of you. This, I knew, was going to be difficult for me. But guess what? Guess what came to my mind tonight? Jada's infectious laugh. So I came here tonight thinking about her laugh. And then that made me smile. And I'm sure you all have heard that laugh and her singing, right? Anyway, my night started out where I was running around getting back late, and I lost my key in one of the 9 rooms and outdoors or somewhere, so I didn't have my vehicle, but I got to borrow one. I was told that, you know, we have to keep it the schedule, and there's a limited time for everyone. But you know how I usually talk a lot, right? So all I could think of was Jada saying, "Mimi, you owe me 10 minutes." And then she'd smile and laugh and say, "I'm only joking." Then, of course, we all encountered Red Light Hill with the lightning, and we didn't, you know, I thought it was gonna be early, but I got here on time. I would like to say that the scholarship is in honor of Jada, and it's chosen 100% anonymously. And that is very important, and thank God it is, because every one of you that applied for this, every one of you are deserving, and the people that didn't apply for it, that are going into other fields, you are all deserving, all of you. And Mr. Brunel and all that was just up here tonight, whether you're a C student, as long as you try the best you can, all your life, what you do, you don't have to be an A student. I just wanted to say also that this year we're giving 3 scholarships of $2,000 each. And it's not me, it's all of you, your families, this community, all of these wonderful people, teachers, all of you. This is from all of you for students, and it will go on in the future, because people keep adding to it. So all the siblings of a lot of her friends here, you know, we might just be here and giving these as long as we can. Thank God we have Emma here. Thanks, Emma. As you know, this scholarship was actually chosen to be, it was very important to Jada to do community service and help little children. She wanted to be a pediatrician. She loved children. She kept asking me if she could adopt a baby sister up until her, like, eighth grade, I think, or ninth. And then, of course, it wouldn't happen. Couldn't, but anyway, that would be too much. But so I guess these important things to her also were that everyone have physical exercise. It's really important for just physical and mental. It's so critical. And so whether it's traditional school sports, and what a year you guys have had, all right, BF, or it's non-traditional, such as, you know, kayaking, scuba diving like me, and, you know, hiking, or, God, this new thing called, what is it called, cornhole? That was on TV the other day. I was like, cornhole, all right, get exercise, do it, all right. So I want to thank all these wonderful parents and teachers, and I want to also thank Jada's 8th grade teachers and 7th and 8th grade teachers, and Mr. Rumrell, who was so instrumental in her life with discipline and music, and thanks to Ashlyn for practicing with her. I want to thank all of you so much for that. Jada was loved by so many of you, and I never felt alone. I never feel alone. My greeting, you give me strength to be strong for all of us. And I never feel alone, because we all feel the same, but we also know Jada's sense of humor and how she felt. And she would want all of you to celebrate and be very happy and go on and just remember her kindness, her spirit, and her infectious laugh, right? I mean, like, we think that. It's very important to me that is what you think of her, is her kindness. So I would have to say tonight, Emma, thank you for being patient. She definitely should be saying, "Mimi, you owe me 10 minutes." But no, I'm getting to the bottom line here. I'm so proud of all of you and all the classmates. You all deserve a scholarship. And I'm so sorry. If I won the lottery tomorrow, I would be giving all 66 of you something. But I didn't win the lottery. But if, as long as you try hard all your life, it's very important, and you'll go very far and be kind and honest and truthful. I love this community. I want to thank all of you for all the support and help for me. I owe you all a million hugs and thank you notes. And I want to also thank Gail Hines. It was so wonderful. Our neighbor, Natalie, up on Natalie Patrick up on Kissel Hill, that's where I lived when Jada and my Christine, Jada's mom, passed away, and her brother, we were up on Kissel Hill. And she was such an incredible teacher, on and out of school all summer. She was incredible. I want to thank Gail. She's responsible for us also for adding more to the scholarship to help all of you, but not all of you, as many as you can. I just want to say also, thank you, Mama. Whether Jane felt strongly also in, you know, she wanted to be a pediatrician, but mental health, psychology, in psychiatry, whether you go to technical school, community college, or regular college, and you might not go to college right away and change your mind and go later, but she really felt strongly about the nursing and medical and health services, and that was also one of the qualifications for this. So with that, I guess I better kind of get to the bottom line here. Thanks, Emma. Thank you. All right, so anyway, when I was chose, these were read to me anonymously, along with Jay's father, and we had no idea who the person was. We had no idea. There was no identifying information. And we would listen to them, and they were read to us with no identifying info. And if there's anything about sports or something like that, that had to be eliminated because I might know who it is. So these are not in any particular order of how we select them. It was just how they were read to us. So the first person that will be receiving this, and Emily will be announcing these recipients, it was this person's essay about the determination. And, you know, Jada wanted everybody to have more than 40 hours of community service. Some of you had hundreds of hours like she did, but sometimes we don't have those opportunities. If we're living out in a rural area, we don't have access to transportation, sometimes Wi-Fi, for God's sakes. So looking at this person and what they said, both of us, Bob and I, looked at each other and said, yep, we have to select this person. So Emma.
Kaylee Aldridge.
Okay, so second one here, this one's very amazing to me. Jane loved working with younger people, right? And you learn so much from younger people, what their problems are, and they share so much with you, looking at you as like a mentor. And this one, this application really struck me hard. It was about school sports psychology. And I thought, wow, that is so critical. You know all the pressure all of you guys have in school sports and everything you go through, especially look at this past year. My God, I wasn't playing and I needed help listening to all of these big game wins, and I'm so proud of all of you students. But this is really important because all these years, when you see so much pressure put on students, young ones, PBs, older, it's really hard, and I was touched by this person's essay about how important he would like to work with children in psychology. And it was so emotional. I'm sorry, it was so emotional to me to see this, right? I'm thinking, he mentors little kids, and he's hearing from the little kids about the pressure. Who could be better at doing this kind of work? So, get a move before Emma pulls me up here. Yeah.
Kaden Haskell.
Oh my God, I've got so touched by that.
Almost done, guys. Thank you. Right. So then, this one was really touching. Now, we were only going to choose two, but I really wanted to be three this year, this special year. You know, Jada would have been with you. And what touched me the most about this one is something I experienced in my life. And it really hit home hard. When I was young, I wanted to be an underwater archaeologist from 7 years old on. But in school, I excelled in bookkeeping, income tax law, business. And my grandfather, when I was about 16, said to me, listen, you love and passionate about diving, but you need to make enough money. There's not many underwater archaeology people hired. You need to make enough money doing what you like also to do so that you can make enough and do what your passion is. And so I really didn't want to, but I took his advice, and I'm so glad I did, because I've been an income tax consultant for more than 40 years, and I've been diving since I've been 12, actually 7, but certified since 12. And this person's, what hit me here with this essay, was this person was passionate about horses. I didn't know if this person owned one, boarded one, rode occasionally. It wasn't, those details weren't there. But what was there was what just came to my heart from my grandfather. And that was focus on academics. She said she was going to focus on academics to be able to have a good career and a good life, to be able to have horse or horses in the future, and also maybe do things with children for therapy. And with that, that just touched my heart. And that was the third selection. Like I said, all of you, I would have chosen. I could only choose three. So Emma, here you go.
Allison Clark.
Grandfather talked to you.
I want to thank you again. Thank you so much for your time. Thank you.
Okay, the next award is the John V. James Memorial Scholarship presented by Mr. Jared James.
Greeting class of 2023. On behalf of the John V. James Scholarship Committee, we would be happy to announce that we are able to give out 8 $1,000 scholarships for the class of 2023. The criteria for this award is as follows. It must be a Bellows Falls Union High School graduate, invested in the community, as we talked a lot about volunteering. It's not just in sports, it could be in anything. Just giving back to your community was always important to my father. An active participant in high school sports, because there's people that knew him, probably saw him at some sort of an event, so that was important as well. Humble and kind, attending an accredited college in the fall or attending a trade program at an accredited school or tech program. The winners for 2023 are Caleb Gia, Caden Haskell, Jameson Nystrom, Juliana McDermott, Jake Moore, Ashlyn Maxfield. And this year, I'm happy to announce that we have two people going into the tech program that we could help fund. And one is Jenna Dolliffe, the next one is Ray Plum.
The next award is the Bill Lockerbie Memorial Scholarship, and that's going to be presented by Mrs. Jessica Lockerbie and Mrs. Kathleen Lockerbie.
Good evening and congratulations to the class of 2023. It's a very exciting time for everybody. My name is Jess Lockerbie. This is Kathy Lockerbie. Some of you knew my husband and Kathy's son, Bill. He passed away in October of 2021. Bill was Bellows Falls sports through and through. He played, he coached, and supported his kids, their friends, and every other athlete on the field report. He was passionate about coaching kids, instilling his knowledge, sportsmanship, and love of whatever sport it happened to be. He was involved with Legion Baseball for 15 years, Westminster Little League, and Babe Ruth. He coached the Packers Pee Wee team for 10 years and the Purple Dogs as well. You could often find him in the crow's nest during high school football games filming, and I can only imagine the audio when the coaches watched those back. If he wasn't coaching, he was on the sidelines cheering them on. There was nothing he loved more than to see kids he coached or helped along the way succeed in any aspect of life, which brings me to the scholarship we started in his memory. The Bill Lockerbie Memorial Scholarship will be awarded to students who go above and beyond in giving back to their community in any way. It will be awarded to students attending a 2 or 4 year college, trade school, or to a student who is just going out into the world to start their life. I am honored to award the first annual Bill Lockerbie Memorial Scholarship and plaque because, as we all know, Bill sure loved a trophy, in the amount of $1,313 each, which is in honor of the number Bill wore throughout his high school and college baseball careers, to two students who exemplify Bill and what he did for his community. Those students are Caden Haskell and Jade Moore. Thank you.
The next award is the Abenaki Snowmobile Club Scholarship presented by Mr. Scott Fletcher.
Good evening. Congratulations, class of 2023. It's good to see all of you out here. To the graduates and their families, we commend you on your achievement and wish you success in your future endeavors. Each year, the Abenaki Snowmobile Club, Grafton Outing Club, gives out a scholarship to a graduating senior at BFUHS who is continuing their education in an advanced course of study. This scholarship is in memory of the founding members of our club and made possible by the generous members who continue to support it today. This year, we had a number of qualified applicants that applied for our scholarship. We generally look at the following criteria in choosing our recipient: leadership, community involvement, hardworking, good moral character, financial need, and involvement in some type of winter sport. Tonight, we will be giving out one award in the amount of $1,000. It is my pleasure to present the 2023 Abenaki Snowmobilers Grafton Outing Club Memorial Scholarship to Miss Juliana McDermott. Follow your dreams.
Is the Bob Joy Memorial Scholarship presented by Mr. Brian Joy.
Congratulations, graduates. The Bob Joy Memorial Scholarship and Community Fund was established in 2018 to honor the memory of my grandfather, Bob Joy. He was involved in many aspects of this community, including coaching baseball and basketball, umpiring from Little League to the college level, a member of the chain gang for Bellows Falls Union High School football, and president of the BFUHS Booster Club. He's most known as president of the Bellows Falls Junior League for many, many years, and while sports was a huge part of his life, he also served on the Rockingham School Board for over 30 years. many times as chair, a member of the committee that built this school, and a past president of the High School Alumni Association, also a member of the Terrier Hall of Fame. His love of this community was something that he passed on to his children and grandchildren, and we hope to continue to honor him by giving back each year. This is our fifth year presenting scholarships to the senior class, and it was our hope to increase the amount and the amount of scholarships we pass on to very deserving young adults each year as they pursue their education. Last year, we were lucky enough to give out scholarships totaling $6,500. This year, we're giving out 8 $1,000 scholarships and 1 scholarship for $2,500 for a total of $10,500. In reviewing the scholarship applications and interviewing these students, we found this was an extremely impressive group. But what stood out to us was the pride that these students showed in their community service, especially in the incredible amount of hours spent helping with our youth programs in this community. It is my honor to present a $1,000 scholarship to Caden Haskell. Miss Emma Hillen. Ezra Holliday. Ashley Maxfield. Jake Moore. Jameson Nystrom. Raymond Plummer. And Miss Grace Warriors. Our final award is given to a student who exemplifies to us the values of community, school, and family. It is an honor to present a scholarship in the amount of $2,500 to Miss Ella Clark.
The next award is the Lindsay K.J. Illingworth Memorial Scholarship. That's going to be presented by Ms. Kaylee Illingworth and Ms. Miley Illingworth. I'd like to first start out by congratulating class of 2023. Tonight, I'm here with the great privilege of honoring my aunt, Lindsay Illingworth. My aunt was a graduate of the class of 2000 here at Bellows Union High School. 15 years ago, my family and I tragically lost my aunt in an automobile accident at the age of 26. It was then that my family decided to give out the annual Lindsay K.J. Illingworth Memorial Scholarship in remembrance. My aunt was a person who was incredibly involved in all aspects of her life, whether it be athletics, music, her community, academics, or devotion to family. She was always so joyfully encompassed in every second of it. So it was decided that this is the criteria we would look at when selecting a graduate who is wishing to continue their education at a higher level. We are proud to say that this year's recipient exceeds the previously mentioned criteria. This student holds numerous accomplishments in both his academic and athletic career. Being a three-sport athlete while maintaining grades that awarded this student for being on the honor roll and high honor roll is not an easy task by any definition. This athlete has been acknowledged with countless awards, mostly reflecting his football career. His hard work at the sport he loves inspired most of his community service, where he helped young kids learn to love the game of football. What is even more impressive is that this student has been class president for his entire time at BFUHS. His action speaks on his tremendous amount of leadership he shows to his community. This student plans on attending Salve Regina University in the fall to further his education. This year's winner of the Lindsay K.J. Illingworth Memorial Scholarship is Keene. Okay, the next award is the Comtois Family Scholarship and Barbara Comtois Angel Award, presented by Mrs. Jean Illingworth and Miss Rachel Comtois.
Congratulations, everybody.
Richard and Barbara Comtois began their careers in married life in Bellows Falls. Richard taught industrial arts and Barbara home economics for a combined 62 years of service to local high schoolers at BFHS and BFUHS. They made their home on Burke Street a loving and caring and supportive place to be. These same characteristics were given to many people in the civic organizations and clubs to which they belonged over the years. Their legacy was to do for others. In this spirit, the scholarship is given in their name to a male or female who plans to pursue a career in teaching, consumer and family sciences, or culinary, industrial arts or other trades, fire safety, and music. This year, we give the Comtois Family Scholarship to a graduate who exemplifies the characteristics of both Richard and Barbara.
This student is planning on a career in a trade. In fact, he has already started his career at ATG in Westminster. After getting his education, he will return to Westminster to pursue a career as a master diesel technician. Even though his grandmother thought he graduated last year, this year's recipient of the Comtois Family Scholarship in the amount of $1,000 goes to Raymond Plummer.
We are also pleased to present our Angel Award in remembrance of my mother, Barbara Comtois, and an avid angel collector, a champion for the underdog, a person who would give the hat off her head if someone needed it, and for us, a true angel on this earth. This award is not about the monetary value, but about the spirit of resiliency and working hard. When it's not easy and growing as a person, this graduate might not otherwise get a chance to receive an award on class night.
We are honored to give the Angel Award in the amount of $100 to Princess Melody Sales and Edler.
Our next award is the Moose Trade Scholarship, presented by Mr. Gerald Rogers.
Congratulations. This year, we are offering a scholarship to a child going out of high school straight into work. That being said, this year we have a young man who, in his junior year, took a liking to welding. While taking advantage of tech school in Springfield. In his senior year, he went back to tech at first and decided to take advantage of the work program at the school offered and decided that he would like to pursue welding as a career. So at this time, I would like to present the Moose Family Scholarship to Trenton Vermont.
Our next award is the Suzanne Grunwald Fat TV Scholarship, which will be presented by Mr. Alex Stradling.
Congratulations, class of 2023. I also want to give a round of applause to the amazing individuals and organizations that are handing out scholarships tonight.
Just the power of the community, people coming together and supporting, and round of applause.
So, I'm Alex Stradling, Executive Director of Falls Area Community Television, and I have the honor of announcing the Susan Grunwald Scholarship, a testament to the transformative potential of stories. A $1,000 investment to students to envision a future in media and arts, a future anchored in the craft of storytelling that weaves us together as a community. So, Susan Grunwald's legacy is the embodiment of this vision. Back in 1995, she reignited public access in our region, taking up the mantle as the first executive director of Fact TV, and later serving as a board member and board chair. Her unwavering commitment and extraordinary vision are the foundations upon which our organization stands today. So, all right, so in paying tribute to that, we had two applicants this year. The criteria were excellence in academics and pursuing a passion in media or in arts, and showing that. And we had two applicants, and we only had one award to give out. So we had a very tough choice, and we decided to award both those applicants because they were both extremely qualified for $1,000. So it is with great joy that we are awarding Ezra Holloway and Caleb Bianchi.
Thanks, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, well, now you get to bear with me even longer as I read the next 16 awards to everybody. So the first one I'm starting with is the Mary T. Shaughnessy Scholarship. Mary Shaughnessy, a graduate of Bellows Falls Union High School in 1938, died in 2021 at the age of 100. Her family feels it is fitting to provide a scholarship to honor her memory and the memory of her mother and father and her four siblings who, by the way, also graduated from Bellows Falls Union High School. Mary was a strong, generous woman. Throughout her life, she kept mentally active by learning new things, and she continuously gave back to the Bellows Falls North Walpole community. Thus, the Mary T. Shaughnessy Scholarship is intended for a young woman who wants to strive for higher education, wants to be of service, and wants to major in science, technology, engineering, or math, fields in which women are still somewhat underrepresented. Therefore, it is with great pleasure that I announce that this year's recipient of the Mary T. Shaughnessy Scholarship of $2,000 is someone who intends to study computer science. The recipient is Mary Wallace. Okay, our next award is the Muriel A. Burbank Scholarship. This is awarded based on a combination of merit and financial need. The recipient will have demonstrated academic ability, concern for school and community, and work experience. I am pleased to announce the six recipients of the $500 Muriel A. Burbank Scholarship are Jane Farnsworth, Austin Allen, Gwendolyn McGrath, Jameson Nystrom, Isabel Perry, and Olivia Ribbons. All right, our next award is the Claire R. Whitcomb Scholarship. This is awarded to a student demonstrating interest in music, either in teaching or performing. The student must have attended BFUHS for at least 2 years and be accepted by an accredited school of higher education for a program 2, 3, or 4 years by June 1st. The student must be outstanding in character, integrity, and leadership. I'm pleased to announce the recipient of the $1,000 Claire R. Whitcomb Scholarship is Ezra Holloway. All right, our next award is the Frank W. Whitcomb Memorial Scholarship. This is awarded to a student demonstrating interest in business administration. The student must have attended BFUHS for at least 2 years and be accepted by an accredited school of higher education for a program of 2, 3, or 4 years by June 1st. The student must be outstanding in character, integrity, and leadership. I'm pleased to announce that the recipient of the $1,000 Frank W. Whitcomb Scholarship is Gwendolyn McGrath. Next one is Randy R. Metcalf Memorial Scholarship. A scholarship has been created in memory of Randy R. Metcalf for students of Bellows Falls Union High School who live in the town of Westminster who will attend any accredited college, junior college, or technical school. First preference will be to a student who wishes to study forestry or pursue environmental studies. Second preference will be to a student going into a vocational trade college, junior college, technical school, or trade school. I am pleased to announce that the recipient of the $500 Randy R. Metcalf Memorial Scholarship is Noah Simino. Okay, the next award is the Virginia Brown Scholarship. This scholarship is given annually to 2 students of the graduating class. Each student receives $1,000 based on having attended BFUHS for at least 1 school year and intends to further their education in the field of education. Further consideration is also given to members of the class who have been active in the school's music programs, drama program, and/or demonstrated a sincere interest in and love of the study of English. I am pleased to award the following 2 students with the $1,000 Virginia Brown Scholarship, Ezra Holloway and Isabel Perry. Okay, the next award is the Lawrence Everett Gray Award. This is presented by the class of 1944 for outstanding sportsmanship displayed throughout the year. The recipient's name will be placed on a plaque in the main hall. This year, I am pleased to announce that the recipient of the Lawrence Everett Gray Award is Jake Moore. Our next award is the Lawrence W. Hadley Award. This is a memorial to the ideals of fair play as characterized by our beloved coach. The recipient's name will be placed on a plaque in the main hall. This year, I am pleased to announce the recipient of the Lawrence W. Hadley Award is Caden Haskell. All right, our next award is the Megan Clifford Clark Scholarship. The Megan Clifford Clark Travel Fund was established in memory of Megan by her family for the purpose of foreign travel. Megan used to look at the mountains surrounding the community and feel trapped. She dreamed of traveling the world and doing Doctors Without Borders for the chance to do that. I am pleased to announce that this year's $1,000 Megan Clifford Clark Scholarship is awarded to Hannah Neff. Our next award is the David Kanga Scholarship. Annually awarded to, oh my gosh, I can't read. Annually awards two scholarships in the amount of $2,000. Scholarships will be need-based and preference will be given to recipients whose effort is above and beyond, hard workers, good academic performance compared to natural ability, and also involved in co-curricular activities. I am pleased to announce that this year's recipients of the $2,000 David Kanga Scholarships are Jake Moore and Isabel Perry. Next award is the Thomas J. Bruno Gallagher Scholarship. This is awarded to the most improved student based on a full four-year academic record and financial need. I am pleased to announce that the recipients of the two $1,000 Thomas J. Bruno Gallagher Scholarships are Ezra Holloway and Noah Simino. John Porter Memorial Award. This is presented to a member of the graduating class who is enrolled in a program of advanced education and has shown courage and determination. I am pleased to announce the recipient of the $1,000 John Porter Memorial Award is Joey Jakes. This next award is the Wyndham Northeast Education Association, which annually awards scholarships in the amount of $500 each to students and former students of Bellows Falls Union High School. This year, the scholarships will be awarded to three members of the senior class. Students majoring in any discipline are eligible to apply, however, preference may be given to those majoring in education. Awards are based on merit, not financial need. This year, the WNEA scholarships for three graduating seniors are awarded to Caden Haskell, Noah Simino, and Grace Warbase. Just kidding. I'm ready. Okay. Paul F. Davis Memorial Science Award is given to a senior for distinguished achievement, sincere interest, and dedication in the physical sciences. This recipient's name will be placed on a plaque in the main hall. This year, I am pleased to announce the recipient is Jake Moore. Right. The Ludlow Rotary Club is awarding a scholarship based on scholastic achievement, financial need, realistic goals, extracurricular activities, and community service. This year, the recipient of the $1,000 scholarship is Olivia Rebetz. Right, and the Award of Excellence for 2023 is given by the National Federation of State High School Associations. This award gives us an opportunity to recognize two BFUHS students for their participation in high school sports based on the following criteria. Treat teammates with respect, treat opponents with respect, shake hands prior to and after contests, respect judgment of contest officials, abide by rules of the contest, and display no behavior that could incite fans. Cooperate with officials, coaches, or directors and fellow participants to conduct a fair contest. Accept seriously the responsibility and privilege of representing school and community. Display positive public action at all times. Live up to a high standard of sportsmanship established by coach or director. I am pleased to announce that this year's recipients of the Award of Excellence 2023 are Caden Haskell and Mary Wallace. All right, and with that, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. Bradley.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're at the home stretch. Still a wonderful, wonderful evening. Next, we're going to move into the Technical Center Awards. We have several students who attended River Valley Technical Center and the Wyndham Regional Career Center. At this time, I'd like to recognize the seniors who completed the tech program and or received an award at either technical center. Please stand when your name is called. Kaylee Aldridge, Criminal Justice, program completed at RBTC, earned industry recognized credentials. Sherry Plum, Health Sciences, program completed at RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley University College, earned industry recognized credentials, and most improved student. Jason Barnsley, Criminal Justice, program completed at RBTC, earned industry recognized credentials, and most improved student. Caleb Beer, Audio Video Production, program completed at RBTC, earned college credit at Community College of Vermont, Skills USA and Future Business Leader of America gold medalist, earned industry recognized credentials and student of the year. Heather Hiller, Criminal Justice, program completed at RBTC, earned industrial recognized credentials. Ezra Holloway, Audio Video Production, program completed at RBTC, earned college credit at Community College of Vermont. Gavin Troy, Business and Financial Services, program completer at RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley Community College, Future Business Leaders of America Gold and Silver Medalist, earned Student of the Year, earned Governor Phil Hoff Vermont Honor Scholarship of $1,000, earned Business Program Scholarship of $1,000, and earned RBTC Director's Award. Ryan Esker, Agriculture and Natural Resources, program completed RBTC, earned industry recognized credentials and Student of the Year. Mr. Natsfield, Health Careers, program completed at WRCC. Vivian McDermott, Health Services, program completed at RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley Community College, earned industry recognized credentials, and earned RBTC Director Scholarship of $750 a year for 4 years. Rogers Merkins, Health Sciences, program completed RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley Community College, earned industry recognized credentials. Dylan Perry, Industrial Trades, program completed at RBTC, earned industry recognized credentials. Ron Sherrill, Advanced Manufacturing and Engineering, program completed at RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley Community College and New Hampshire Technical Institute, Skills USA Gold and Bronze Medalist, earned industry recognized credentials, and Advanced Manufacturing and Engineering Program Scholarship of $1,500. Mel Simino, Health Sciences, program completed RBTC, earned college credit at River Valley Community College, earned industry recognized credentials. Tyler Thomas, Industrial Trades, program completed at RBTC, earned industry recognized credentials, Student of the Year, Industrial Trades Program Scholarship of Toolkit for Career, Townfair Tire Toolship Award of $500 in items for career. And Wiley Woods, Audio Video Production, program completed RBTC, earned college credit at Community College of Vermont, earned industry recognized credentials, most improved student.
We brought me a first grade of students. And next, I'd ask Wyatt Lescore to stand up again, please. With military recognitions. As we express our gratitude, we must never forget the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but live by them. That's by John F. Kennedy. Joining the military is a big commitment. This commitment is not to be taken lightly. Please congratulate Wyatt Lescord, who will enter into the next phase of his life by joining the Vermont Army and National Guard. Okay, and moving forward, the Bryant Chucking Grinder Company Scholarship Committee gives out two awards annually, the Regular Academic Achievement Award and the Nicholas A. Leds Memorial Academic Award. Both awards are valued up to $3,500 and are based on high academic achievement and require maintenance of a high annual and cumulative GPA. I'm pleased to announce the recipient of the Regular Academic Achievement Award is Mary Wallace. And the recipient of the Nicholas A. Leds Memorial Academic Award is Austin Mann. The next one is the Peggy and Fred Warrior Student Achievement Award. And this is awarded annually to two students in Bellows Falls Union High School graduating class in memory of both Peggy and Fred. This award is earned by two students who have demonstrated kindness, academic capability, a strong work ethic, and a sense of compassion that Peggy would have admired. I'm pleased to announce this year's two recipients of the $500 Peggy and Fred Warriors Student Achievement Awards are Caden Haskell and Grace Warriors. Francis Coyne Memorial Scholarship. This is awarded to a student who is entering the field of education. I'm pleased to announce that this year we have one recipient of the $250 Francis Coyne Memorial Scholarship, and that is Ellen Clark. Ludlow American Legion Auxiliary is proud to present the Gold Star Family Memorial Scholarship to a senior who has a good moral character, initiative, and potential leadership qualities, scholastic ability, and financial need. I'm pleased to announce that this year the 1,000 Gold Star Family Memorial Scholarship is awarded to Olivia. The Ludlow American Legion Post 36 Award is proud. They're proud to present the PDCs, Carlton Lawrence, Henry Vale, David Garland, and Clark Ferris Education to a member of the class of 2023. These men were and are longtime members of Ludlow Post 36. In their tenures, they were and have been dedicated advocates for our youth seeking a higher education. Their kindness to others and their beliefs that all young adults should be able to see their dreams come true inspired all of us. This year, we are proud to present the $500 award to Raymond Plyer.
The Vincenzo Ruggiero Memorial Scholarship is awarded to two students who have attended Bellows Junior High School for a minimum of 2 years, has been involved in cultural activities, has community involvement, and has a hallmark of school spirit. Recipients must also have a lively character, like Vinny, and most of all, be passionate for anything you choose to do. I'm pleased to announce that this year's recipients of the $500 Vincenzo Ruggiero Memorial Scholarships are Caden Haskell and Mary Wolf. The Knights of Columbus Student Achievement Award. This award is given by the Knights of Columbus to a senior who demonstrated strong academic ability. I'm pleased to award the $500 to Joey James. The John Bumper Malley Achievement Award. This award is given by the Knights of Columbus to a senior who demonstrates strong academic ability. I'm pleased to award the $300 John Bumper Malley Achievement Award to Emma Hillip. The DAR Good Citizenship Award. The significance of the DAR Good Citizenship Award pin is as follows. The rim, 13 stars, represent 13 original colonies. Band of blue enamel identifies it is with our society. Qualities of good character, which we emphasize. Dependability, service, leadership, patriotism, are all titles of four books in the center suggesting schools. Circling these is the laurel wreath of honor. Behind them, the torch of understanding. Pleased to announce this year's recipient of the DAR with Citizenship Award is Grace Morris. Governor Phil Hough, Vermont Honor Scholarship. This program was created in 1965 by the Vermont State Legislature to recognize academic achievement among Vermont's graduating high school seniors. In 1999, the Vermont State Legislature increased the dollar amount to $1,000 and added eligibility criteria requiring nominees to demonstrate participation in extracurricular activities and/or community service. I'm pleased to announce this year's recipient of the $1,000 Vermont Honor Scholarship, Mary Wallace. The Fort Memorial Scholarship is awarded to students attending Bellows Junior High School or any placement thereof. The recipients will have good scholastic record, good citizenship, and financial need. I'm pleased to award the following six students with $1,000 Fort Memorial Scholarship: Ella Clark, Jenna Dodd, Caden Haskell, Ashlyn Maxfield, Gwendolyn McGrath, and Grace Warriors. Okay, the VPA Scholar Activity Award. This award gives us an opportunity to recognize Bellsville Junior High School students for their accomplishments academically and participation in VPA-sponsored varsity sports or activities. Each of the recognized students must be a graduating senior, have a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher, have participated in a VPA-sponsored sport or activity in Vermont for at least 4 years, and has exhibited outstanding school leadership and citizenship. I'm pleased to announce that this year's recipients of the VPA Scholar Activity Award are Caitlin Gia, Caden Haskell, Gavin Joy, Austin Mallon, Jake Moore, Mary Wallace, and Grace Warriors. Okay, UVM Green and Gold Award. The University of Vermont Green and Gold Scholarship is an academic merit scholarship awarded to academically strongest rising high school senior from every Vermont public secondary school. The scholarship fund was established through a gift made by the family of the late Genevieve Patrick. As a Green and Gold Scholarship recipient, the recipient is entitled to a 4-year merit scholarship at UVM, currently valued at over $65,000. I'm pleased to announce that this year's recipient of the Green and Gold is Mary Wallace. Moving on. I'd like to first say just a few thank yous. We're not quite done yet, but making all this happen, especially every year as the our awards and our money seem to just keep going up. This is a very tough job, and I'd like to thank everyone that was involved in it. There's way too many names for me to stand up here, albeit on midnight. But three people that did an excellent job in pulling a lot of this together, and one in particular who was, I can only describe as phenomenal. Rebecca and Stacey in our front office, they've done a lot of work around graduation, around class night. It's very important. Take it with the utmost seriousness, and the kids will tell you, you know, we treat it with the dignity and respect that it deserves because it's an important time in their life. And most of all, I'd like to thank Melba Ross, who she took countless times checking, double checking, keeping me straight. I was like, yeah, thanks. And again today, I checked it again, you know. It's what makes these nights fantastic. Thank you, Mel. That was a great job. Okay, a few more things. I'd like to ask Ms. Heather Murphy to come up and talk a little bit alumni with her daughter.
Good evening, future alumni. My name is Heather Murphy Hicks, and it is with great pride that I am here tonight representing the Bellows Falls High School Alumni Association. It is with distinct privilege to welcome you, the class of 2023. into our ranks this coming Sunday at our alumni meeting. Our association has a rich history spanning generations of Bellows Falls High School and Bellows Falls Union High School graduates. We are full of proud traditions and accomplishments that we hope, with your help, will continue for years to come. Alumni plan is starting last fall, and the festivities finally start tonight. What an amazing night we just witnessed, with thousands of dollars awarded in scholarships from the Alumni Association, individuals, and many local organizations. Our alumni tradition continues tomorrow night with a presentation of the Alumni Award, which is awarded to a member of the graduating class who the Faculty Awards Committee deems the most worthy, judging of scholarship, character, and trustworthiness. We continue our traditions by hosting two dances on Friday evening from 8 p.m. to midnight at the American Legion and the Waypoint Center. You, the class of 2023, will be our guests at the Alumni Association at the Waypoint Center. This dance will give you opportunity to meet and celebrate with many other members of the Alumni Association. I encourage you to attend. On Saturday, other classes will be celebrating reunions. This includes the class of 1973, the 50-year class, and our other guests for the weekend. During the day on Saturday, we will play alumni games. Not ready to hang up that field hockey stick, soccer ball, or basketball quite yet? I hope not. Come join former BFUHS students in pickup games right here on your campus. On June 18th, in the square at 12:30, the crowning of the Alumni Queen will take place. The 2023 Grand Marshal, Bill Murphy, and myself will be present for the crowning of the Queen. Your 2023 Alumni Queen nominees are Mary Wallace, Jenna Dolliff, Grace Warrius, Juliana McDermott, and Ella Clark. As the graduating class, you will be featured as one of the first floats in the parade. This used to say you were the first floats, but we have a really ambitious 50-year class this year that has built the float. So, the Association 50-year class, the class of 73, and don't forget to show, as you enter the square, I ask you to acknowledge the other guests of the Alumni Association, the 50-year class, the class of 1973, and don't forget to show your school spirit by singing our school song in the square. Following the parade at 4:00, we will hold our annual meeting in the auditorium at the Bellows Falls Middle School. There, you will be officially welcomed into the Alumni Association. Everyone should be there. We will also recognize the Queen and her court and the Alumni Scholarships winners from tonight. You won't have to give a speech, but you should be prepared to sing the school song again. There is nothing like a alumni weekend. Alumni fever is a common phrase used by many association members. I just know you will all catch it. As you begin your first alumni weekend, have fun. Enjoy your time together. I ask that you watch out for and take care of one another and enjoy every minute of your first alumni experience. On behalf of the members of the Alumni Association, congratulations, class of 2023.
All right, folks, we're almost there. We're going to have one more dedication tonight. We're going to ask Mr. Ken Haskell to come up and do our Euro presentation tonight.
First, I'd like to thank Miss Lana for helping me and create this awesome yearbook, and I'm very happy that we got it in time, which is pretty awesome. But this year, the class of 2023, I'd like to dedicate the yearbook to our late and beloved friend, James Fall. With a smile that could light up a room and a heart that could love all, Jada connected with so many people in such a short time that she had. While Jada is not physically here to graduate with us, she is here and will forever be here as a pillar of the class of 2023. Jada was an amazing person filled with an amazing soul, and she cared for all. Her charisma and attitude towards life made people gravitate towards her. Jada was extremely intelligent and an amazing athlete from school to sports. She never let anything best her. She played 3 sports a year and always maintained high grades. She played her heart out every time she played her sports. One of many things everyone should remember about Jada is her infectious laugh. It was the most contagious thing and could brighten anyone's day. Jada herself was capable of that. In many eyes, Jada was truly the definition of beautiful inside and out. Jada loved so much and she loved everything to the fullest extent. From playing instruments, to skiing, to always chasing that sunset, she loved every moment. Jada loved being near the water. She also would frequently talk about her love for Colorado. Jada was such an amazing person that many of us had the privilege to call her a friend. And much more. She had so much energy and was always willing to convert that into helping people and was always trying to be the best that she could be all the time. This list about Jada's beautiful, amazing life could go on forever, but truly knowing Jada, she wouldn't want me to. She truly will be missed, but we should all cherish the times we had with her, remember her closely, dearly to our hearts. Thank you so much.